Yabba dabba fruit delicious do. Hello everyone. Welcome to a festive episode of A Crep from the 80s. I am, of course, your host, Chris Siever, and we are just in the beginning of December 2023, and my favorite time of year, Christmas indeed. This week's episode is going to be about my favorite Christmas movies that I watch every year. And if not every year, then every other year, you see. And I want to also just start out by thanking you folks who jumped on the Christmas sale this year, the holiday sale. It's over. It's done because, well, as far as the new titles are concerned, the Low Budget Pictures Classics Volume 7, which is a double feature of the Blue Cheese Brothers and Teen Ape and Bubbles' 'Twas the Funk Before Christmas, older 2000 shorts that we did that were highly sought after. And we also sold out of the new Saturday Morning Sleepover Volume 6 or 7? 6? I think it's Volume 6. Volume 5, maybe? Volume 5? The Christmas edition. Whatever it is. Maybe it's 5. They are sold out. And thanks to you guys. Thanks to you guys. Both of them are gone. We still do have... I've got a few copies left of LBP Volume 2, Volume 3, and I think... the Warlock Home Video Volume 2, which has Happy Holidays, which is one of our Christmas shorts, as well as the Dingleberries. I think I've got a few of those left. So if you want to get a hold of those, just get a hold of me, and they are on sale for the Christmas season. Again, we've only got a few left, but you can get the 4 Blu-rays with 2 movies each on them. I'm doing those for $50 shipped. If you wanted to get those, add to your collection, complete your collection, whatever it is. So you can just get a hold of me at warlockhomevideo@gmail.com. But yeah, so Christmas, we're here. 'Tis the season. 2023, if you've been a follower of this channel for a long time, you know that Christmas is my favorite time of year. You may be wondering, Chris, why? You're Mr. Horror. You love horror and you make horror comedies and, you know, you've been watching horror your whole life and blah, blah, blah. And yes, and that's primarily why Halloween isn't as big a deal for me as it is as Christmas is. Because, you know, for the most part, I'm living Halloween 24/7. you know, it's everywhere. It's in the house. It's, you know, it is the theater room. It's just the horror is in the blood. But Christmas has always been my favorite holiday from a wee lad until now. I hold it very high up, in high esteem, as my favorite holiday. And just my favorite time of year in general. I love the sights. I love the smells. I love the movies and TV specials. And I love the foods and the family and gift giving and all of that. And as you know, you've heard me talk about it before, but... Christmas is the one time of year where materialism runs rampant in the Siever household. And it's almost like any sort of money that I make throughout the year, it's, you know, it's all going to go towards that Christmas. And it can be spotty, you know. That's primarily why I do these sales every year. Even all the way, you know, when I start the fall sales, it all goes to the Christmas season and Christmas shopping. And, you know, giving my family, I love seeing their happy faces when they open presents and things like that. And, you know, so it's just awesome. And so I'm going to talk about some of the movies that puts me in that holiday spirit. Some of them are going to be, like I said, year rounds. I've watched since I was a kid in the 80s, and was fortunate enough to see in theaters a lot of them. And a few of them are brand new additions to the movie watching landscape for the Seaver family Christmases and whatnot. So I can start off with at least two of those right now. There's a movie that came out 2 or 3 years ago, and it's called Fat Man. And it stars Mel Gibson as Santa Claus. And it's an action movie. But I really dig it. I think it's fun. It's weird. It's definitely a different take on the whole Santa thing. And it works for me. Both my wife and I really enjoy it. And I do have it on Blu-ray. I did not put it in the list. I didn't put it in this pile. But it's you know, it's newer, and it's adding to the tradition. Another one came out last year, starring David Harbour as Santa Claus, and it's called Violent Night. And it's an awesome, you know, Christmas, bloody action, fantasy, magical Christmas movie. It really is like a violent action film with heart, starring Santa and a bunch of elves. And it's awesome. It's so fun. We saw it in New York City last year during the holidays. It has been out on Blu-ray. I never got it because I was waiting for that 4K, and the 4K recently came out, but I don't get stuff for me usually, and certainly not around the holidays. So it always goes on my Amazon wish list. I have two Amazon wish lists, one that is general geekery and one that is 80s and 90s themed. And so the Violent Night 4K is on my wish list, and I'm pretty sure my wife got it for me. I would think so. But it's great, and we're gonna watch it for the our Christmas party that we host every year. We do a Christmas Seavage family Christmas get together every holiday, you know, sometime in December, and whole bunch of people come, the gang, you know, and we just veg out. We watch Christmas horror movies usually, Christmas specials, and we just veg out all day through the night. And so I'm looking forward to that. This year, we're going to have some returning people who haven't been to the Christmas event in a while, and some who haven't been there at all. So I'm excited. And we'll have videos. We're going to be doing some videos for the channel coming up, with a few of those people in it. Anyway, we'll be adding Violent Night to that this year. But so those are newer films on the list that I watch. And most of these, I mean, pretty much these, so these are movies that are definitely Christmas films, or there's Christmas themes. Christmas is happening while the movie is happening. And, you know, a perfect example of that is Die Hard. If we don't watch it every year, we definitely watch it every other year. And again, Die Hard is a movie that you can watch any time of the year, really. And we have. But it's, you know, it's a tradition in this household. You can do the argument until you're blue in the face. Is it a Christmas movie? Is it in a Christmas movie? You know, it is what it is. It's got Christmas in it. It takes place around Christmas. There's some Christmas cheer and, you know, crazy action, and it's Die Hard. Come on now. Another one that I 100% wholeheartedly agree that is a Christmas movie, but it's also a comedy horror, is Gremlins. I, of course, grew up with Gremlins, and it's on my list. And Gremlins, again, is a movie that I watch whenever, but it has a special feeling around the Christmas time. So, Gremlins is one of those. This is another one. It's like, you know, you hear some people say, it's not a Christmas movie, but I mean, Christmas is happening. Yuletide cheer is happening during the movie. It just happens to be a Batman film, and it is my favorite Batman film, with my favorite Batman, Michael Keaton. And I love this movie. And boy, oh boy, on 4K, guys. Whew, Warner Brothers, they did a tremendous job with Batman 89 and Batman Returns on 4K. They both look spectacular. Spectacular. But, you know, I mean, Christmas. It's Christmas. Definitely. Well, so this one is interesting. It's not necessarily a Christmas movie, but I feel compelled to watch it around, you know, November, December, January even. And this is 1985's Better Off Dead. I really enjoy this movie. I think it's great. I've liked it since the 80s. And, you know, I think it's one of John Cusack's best. Savage Steve Holland, brother. Better Off Dead. If there were a 4K, I would get a 4K of this. The Blu-ray is kind of weak, but it's better than the DVD. So, this is another one that is a little like, I guess I have a few of those coming up here, guys. You know, I keep saying it, but, you know, it's Christmas adjacent, if you will. For some of these. This one is not even close. This one's not even close. This is not a Christmas movie. This is just a straight up comedy that you can watch all year round. And I do. This is a movie that, another one of those theatrical experiences I had growing up, 1986. My mom and myself went to see this. I love this movie and I love these actors. These comedians. But it is Three Amigos. Yeah, Three Amigos. Yep. I was 9 years old when this hit theaters. And again, I've told this story before, and I've certainly told the story of, like, our family were theater people. We went to the movies a lot. So since I was a baby, we were going to the movies. So I was lucky enough growing up in the 80s to see so many theatrical first runs, you know, which is great. So Three Amigos, the reason that it has a special Christmas attachment to me is because every Christmas Eve, so I lived with my great-grandparents and my great-aunt, and, you know, my mom and other family members were very close around us. We were all sort of lived in the same vicinity. But we would throw a Christmas Eve party, and we had a lot of our neighborhood friends come to the Christmas Eve party. And I'm not talking like, you know, it was like a kids' party. I'm saying like it was the family invited other, you know, neighborhood friends, family members. Yes, they were kids, and yes, they were kids that I played with in the neighborhood and whatnot. But we had these events, these Christmas Eve events, and they were great. And some of the things that we served for food back then, I'm still serving now when we do our Christmas event and or on Christmas Eve, you know, when it's just Katie and I. So, you know, the family would, the adults would be, you know, in the dining room, and they would be laughing and drinking and, you know, eating appetizers and whatnot and doing their thing. And then us kids were always in the living room watching TV. And so when Three Amigos came out on VHS, I duped it. And I did that a lot because early on we got two VCRs in the 80s. And so I started like renting and just duping so many movies. And so we had Three Amigos, and Three Amigos for some reason became a movie that I would put on during those Christmas Eve parties for me and my, you know, childhood friends. And we'd watch Three Amigos. I mean, we also watched, you know, other movies that are on this list and Christmas specials and things like that. But Three Amigos, even Spaceballs was in that list, you know. So it was just, I don't know. And then, so Three Amigos became sort of like 3 or 4 years in a row. You know, they'd come over and then us kids would be like, are we going to watch Three Amigos? Are we going to watch Three Amigos? You know, and we would like recite the dialogue and we'd do the musical numbers that are in it and whatnot. And it just became a thing. And so there you go. I mean, Three Amigos is like, it has nothing to do with Christmas, but it has those nostalgic Christmas memories for me because of what we did. So longer. Tried to cut it down, guys. Anyway, there you go. Let's see. Let's continue with these like movies that are just sort of on the cusp and has bits. Oh, I did have, I did have Fat Man in here. Fat Man is in here. That's Mel Gibson as Santa. Walton Goggins is also in it. Great. It's just a really fun, crazy Christmas action movie. I don't know. It tickles me. It tickles my non-you-doobles. Let's see if we can get some other... Okay, the rest of these are pretty much all Christmas. And these are Christmas adjacent. Christmas is happening during them, but they're not primarily, the thrust of the films are not Christmas themed. So this is another one, which happens to be another, so the writer and director, not of this movie, but he's a writer and director, primarily a writer, Shane Black, loves to write movies when Christmas is happening. You know, he did it with Lethal Weapon. He's done it with Kiss Kiss Bang Bang, and he did it with Iron Man 3. And so this one is Christmas is happening, but is a straight up crazy action movie. And it's called The Long Kiss Goodnight. Love this film. Saw it in theaters, have had it on VHS and then DVD and then Blu-ray. And this is another movie that I would love for 4K one day. I don't know if it'll ever happen, but, you know, and just recently watched this with my buddy Billy when he was here. We love the film. Still holds up, and it's still a great time. I mean, Christmas happens in this film, and so does New Year. But it ain't a Christmas book, but I certainly watch it. Again, I can watch this any time of the year, but it feels right during Christmas. Even though a lot of these movies that I talk about like that all came out in like the summer when they opened, you know, but they're, you know, Christmas adjacent, and Ghostbusters 2 is one of those. This one now, so this one I watch every year, and I've watched this every year regardless of the holidays, but I watch it every year, and I've probably watched it since the late 80s every year. I adore this film. This is Trading Places. So funny. Yes, there's Christmas in it. It takes place around Christmas and New Year's. but it's not necessarily a Christmas film. But man, do I love it. For everything. The writing, the performances, the music, directing, of course, John Landis. I love it. And it is one of my favorite films of all time. But I make sure this gets watched regardless every year. There is a 4K that is also on my wish list, and I think probably somebody got it for me. But yeah, and then I'll retire this and give it away or sell it or like that for $5. Here's one. This isn't a year round, but this is definitely on my list, and we watch it off and on. And this is another one that I've watched since I was probably an early teen. Scrooged. I did not see this in theaters because I remember at the time when it came out, I remember being sort of like kind of poo-poo about it, only because I really love A Christmas Carol. I love that tale regardless. And I felt like, oh, what are they doing with this? Like, this version, this is weird. And you know, and that was just my stupid, like, just seeing the trailers, you know, or the TV ads and just being like, you know, because I love Bill Murray. But I don't know what it was that just made me like, until I rented it. And then I was like, oh, my God, why didn't I go see this? But, yeah, Scrooged. It's a classic. It is on 4K, but I don't need it. I don't need the 4K. Great movie, really fun, and certainly it's a Christmas Carol. It's a Christmas Carol. Now let's get into that. So, two of these, I definitely watch every single Christmas. And those are Black Christmas and Silent Night, Deadly Night. Two classics I've watched since the late 80s. I love them. They're pure magic for as far as I'm concerned. Mixing Christmas and horror and just terror and sleaze. But man, I love them. And I always, always want to find out what's on the warm side of the door. Do you know what I'm saying? And then added to that list of Christmas horror, not as many times do I watch this one because it's basically half the movie is you're watching the first movie again and then you get some of the other stuff. But it's not as tight and it's not as complete as far as I'm concerned as the first movie. But I do like it. So it is on my list. And then with this collection, this was a recent collection from Vestron. But I had always watched part five. Part five, like three and four really suck. And five sucks, but five is so much stupid fun. That it's a great time with an audience. It's good to laugh at. It's goofy. The effects are great and cheesy. Mickey Rooney being some evil, evil toy maker. It's right up my alley. So I'm glad that Five is on Blu-ray, with all these special features and whatnot. So, that's on the list too. Okay. Yep. Oh, this is some good stuff. Next, let's see. So I am an unabashed Jim Henson fan, Muppet fan. Anything Muppets I glommed onto and I loved from a very early age, from Sesame Street to The Muppet Show to The Great Muppet Caper in theaters, Dark Crystal, Labyrinth, anything Jim Henson, I was fascinated by. I just loved what he did. I loved the characters that he and Frank Oz and his whole team created. I'm still very much in love with the Muppets. And so this is the DVD. I think we didn't get a Blu-ray of this yet because they started showing this on, they, you know, when Disney Plus came out, it went on Disney Plus, and it looks pretty great on Disney Plus. So we haven't gotten a Blu-ray yet. But the Muppet Christmas Carol, it is probably my favorite Christmas Carol version of all. It's just too many things adding up to make a masterpiece, as far as I'm concerned. But yeah, so that's right here. Muppet Christmas Carol. And in that vein, we got Jim Henson, Emmett Otter's Jug Band Christmas. I don't watch it every year, but it's probably an every other year type of thing. Something I also watch every year is the Muppet Family Christmas special that I've watched since it aired in 1987. Love it. Love it. I was 10 years old when that special came out, and that blew my mind, because not only were you getting characters from Sesame Street and the Muppets, but also Fraggle Rock, all in one freaking special. It was awesome. It's insane. And I love it. And then we've got, I mean, it's classic. And I don't know why I haven't gotten this on Blu-ray yet. But it's Charlie Brown Christmas. I love the Peanuts. I love Charlie Brown. Their specials, their holiday specials, were staples of growing up for me. And so this is a watch every single year without question. This is a every few years. This is sometimes it's back to back to back every year, and sometimes it's every other year. But this is also a classic, Ernest Saves Christmas. For some uncrumbly reason, this is not on Blu-ray. It's never had a Blu-ray release. The other Ernest films that matter are on Blu-ray. But Ernest Saves Christmas has never been on Blu-ray. And currently, the only way you can watch the movie in widescreen is on Disney Plus. And so we've been doing it from that, because this is a ugly, even if it says 185 widescreen, it ain't. This is a terrible transfer. But for the longest time, this is all we had. But thank you, Disney Plus, for giving us a widescreen version. I love Ernest. I love Jim Varney. You know what I mean? Okay, so this one I do watch it every year. But it's not like a super uber favorite of mine, like it was so many other kids growing up. I did go see it in theaters. And I liked it. I just didn't go gaga for it the way so many people do, even in my current family and friend group. But this is Home Alone. You know, I was 13 when this came out, and while I liked it, I didn't go nuts for it. But it's still a Christmas movie, and there's still some great stuff in it, and, you know, John Hughes all the way. Chris Columbus, 1-2 punch. I still gotta watch it every year. Now this is a probably we watch every other year, and it is one of my favorites, but it's not my favorite vacation film. But it's Christmas Vacation. I will end up getting that 4K. I saw the difference between the Blu-ray and the 4K, and the 4K looks wonderful. So I will get that at some point. So I love the film, but there's a couple strikes for me. And I saw this in theaters with the family. I do not like Johnny Galecki and Juliette Lewis as the Griswold kids. I never did. Even in the theater, I was just like, oh no. No, thanks. They just didn't have... They didn't have the personalities of... And I know, you know, it was a running gag for the Griswold kids to change each film. But in Vacation and European Vacation, Rusty and Audrey were real characters and really fun to watch. A great integration with the Griswold family. And then with Christmas Vacation, it's they just are kind of... I just didn't vibe with them. Everything else is great, but I just don't like the Griswold kids. But yeah, so. Oh, this is fun. Actually, in fact, like, I should have more of these. The Hanna-Barbera Christmas stuff. Hanna-Barbera is my jam. All right? I do not like the Looney Tunes, any of that shit. I always loved Hanna-Barbera and all the cartoons coming out of that factory. And they make some great Christmas specials. And this is one of them. And so they, I mean, they've got some great Flintstones Christmas specials. There's Christmas specials throughout the Hanna-Barbera verse. That I like. I also like, I had it. I'm sorry. I had it. I don't know where it went as far as cartoon Christmas events. And why I don't have them. Anyway. Oh, Hanna-Barbera. Yeah. So like, you know, the Smurfs Christmas special. And there was, of course, the He-Man and She-Ra, Christmas special, which I do have on DVD. Yeah, just any, you know, in fact, like any time, like any of my sitcoms that I loved did Christmas specials, it was awesome. It was just mixing two things that I love so much. And there's a lot of that. And certainly I put those together for the Saturday morning sleepovers. When we did Christmas editions, like we're doing one in a couple of weeks. But yeah, Yogi's First Christmas was fun. But my favorite animated Christmas shows, Christmas specials, they did both animation, traditional animation, and Animagic, which is stop motion, but Rankin and Bass. And you saw me with their book earlier. This book is awesome. It's everything Rankin Bass. It's the Enchanted World of Rankin Bass. But man, I love Rankin Bass. Since I was probably 4 years old, I've watched every Rankin and Bass special every year. And that includes Rudolph. That includes Frosty the Snowman. That includes Santa Claus is Coming to Town. And on this has also got The Leprechaun's Christmas Gold, Pinocchio's Christmas, The Stingiest Man in Town, Rudolph's Shiny New Year, Nestor, which I always hated. Hated Nestor and I hated Little Drummer Boy. I do not like those. Frosty's Winter Wonderland. Twas the Night Before Christmas was probably my favorite 2D hand-drawn animation from Rankin and Bass. I love Twas the Night Before Christmas from them. With the rats and the clock tower and with the mice, sorry. Love it. Love it. Even a miracle needs a hand. And then this has also got Rudolph and Frosty's A Christmas in July. But, shit. They don't make them like they used to, man. Rankin and Bass, I love them so much. Love them so much. But they are every single year. Can't go a holiday without watching them. They just mean so much to me. It's It's Christmas time. It's the nostalgia. It's just that warm, fuzzy feeling. And I just love it. And that can lead into my favorite Christmas film of all time. But I'm going to put in a couple of newer honorable mentions as well. And this is from a few, both of them are from a few years ago. And I should have added them earlier when I was talking about the newer films. But I also really like the Christmas Chronicles, the first one, not the second one, with Kurt Russell as Santa Claus. I thought it was great. And since it debuted, Katie and I do watch that every year. And then I can't remember if it was last year or the year before, but there's another movie that came out on Netflix. It's called The Boy Called Christmas, I think it is. And that was great. And that was really great. And I want to add that to the list as well. Because I thought it was pretty whimsical and magical. I liked it. But the coup de grace. The 1.21 gigawatts of Christmas films. And my heart and my passion and my love for Christmas. Without question, since 1984, the movie came out in 83, but since 1984, this movie is a every single year, without question, it is my favorite Christmas film of all time, A Christmas Story. It means so much to me. I can recite this thing backwards and forwards. It doesn't matter how many times I've seen it. I still just love it. I laugh. I smile. I get those warm feelings. And it's forever always been my favorite Christmas movie. I think it's just awesome. Awesome. And it's celebrating its 40th anniversary this year. Crazy, right? Crazy, right? But wait. You know what else is celebrating its 40th anniversary this year? Trading Places. It's also 40 this year. Christmas Story and Trading Places. My gosh. It's so good. It's so good. And it looks great on 4K. It's so good that I might even watch it right after this. It's coming to theaters for 2 days, December 10th and December 13th in select theaters. I'm probably going to go to the theater and see it. It doesn't matter if I own it. It doesn't matter if I have a top of the line, you know, 4K projector and huge screen and Dolby Atmos surround. It doesn't matter. Something about going to see it in the movie theater would be so magical. And I'm probably going to go see it on the 13th, I think. On the 13th. So, there you go, folks. These are the movies that I love and mean a lot to me. And I try to watch every year during the holiday season. What are your favorites? Let me know. Let me know. I want to know down in the comments. I'm sure a lot of these are on your list as well. But hey, there's all kinds. There's so many different movies that can be categorized as Christmas films, and so many Christmas films that I personally don't get down with. But what do you get down with? I want to know. I want to know what your Christmas rituals are. You know. What brings you back to your childhood during the holidays and those warm and fuzzy feelings? I just want to know. Maybe you'll got some recommendation that old Sievich could try out for the holidays. Anyway, thanks for putting up with this, guys. We got a bunch of episodes coming this month alone, December. Which is great. We've got some stuff coming up with Casey and I And like I said, we got some stuff coming up with Andrew and Meredith. And they are, you know, a little bit of both. It's Christmas themed and just, you know, 80s themed. And then Casey and I also do our end of the year, what we loved in pop culture for, you know, 2023, what we're looking forward to in 2024. So, but thanks. Thanks a lot for watching. Thanks for sticking at the by the channel. I just want to, again, let everybody know that, you know, I give a big, hearty thank you for continuing to support the channel and keep watching this stuff. People who support my films and help me make a living and buy my films and you know, enjoy them. And don't forget, folks, there was a documentary that was made about me and my films and the people, my friends that are in my films and have helped me make these movies for, you know, next February, it's going to be 33 years since I've been doing it. But a documentary was made from 2019 till 2021. Zach Olivares, a filmmaker from Seattle, made this documentary about us. And he won a whole bunch of awards. It was in festivals. And last year, it finally made it to Amazon Prime and Tubi. So it's out there. It's called Zero Budget Heroes, The Legend of Chris Seaver and Low Budget Pictures. If you want to see what it was like, me growing up from 1977 till 2021, being a movie kid, a horror kid, a toy 80s kid, it's all there. And you can watch it right now. And if you do, and if you like it, please go to Letterboxd. It's a movie review site. And Zach put it up on Letterboxd. And it would be great if you could, you know, give him some love over there on Letterboxd and let him know what you thought of the documentary and all that good stuff. So thanks again, guys, and I hope you guys have a great holiday. We'll see you in some coming up episodes real quick. And, yeah, 'tis the season, my friend. 'Tis the season to be savage. Have a holly jolly Christmas. It's the best time of the year.